For this entry, we're finally going to exit the 90s and travel into the 21st century. And boy were things black and bleak. The era started with a tragic event. Of course, I'm talking about reality TV shows like Survivor really taking off. Also, some small event happened in 2001. It was really the catalyst that led to further popularization of the goth and emo genre. You know, stuff like My Chemical Romance, you know, Hot Topic. I was never a fan of that stuff. Yeah, surprising given how dark and foreboding you could expect a black mage to be, but I never cared for MCR, and only ever went into Hot Topic like once or twice when my friends dragged me in there while we were at the mall, back when teens actually went to those places. I mean, this is the era that turned the Prince of Persia from the handsome, generic-looking dude from the late 90s to this other guy who's super into, like, Nightwish and Avril Lavigne. So games are definitely trying to fit the zeitgeist of the times, even if it didn't make a whole lot of sense for it. One thing I was interested in was rock. The music genre, not the mineral. And I guess I also had, like, a slight interest in Gothic architecture. Living in America, all our buildings seem so ho-hum and generic. There's not much to distinguish, like, one city from another. It all feels really samey. So seeing something that was different was neat, and the ambience really added to the scenery. Devil May Cry, with this gorgeous Gothic architecture and demonic vibes, fit perfectly into what I was interested in. And I didn't have the best start with the series. Some might consider it the worst, actually. My first Devil May Cry game was the often maligned sequel. So you can't accuse me of nostalgia towards the first game, of coloring my attitude towards the franchise. Why did I start the second game? Because that was the one my friend had. Imagine playing that while having someone there insist, "I promise the original game was better," only to have me ask, "Then why didn't you buy that one?" Yeah, I was hesitant to gamble on the first game when 2 felt so blah. But I saw it for a few dollars at GameStop, so I took the plunge. And boy, was I glad I did. Oh, I loved the game. It was so over the top compared to the sequel. And Dante, he was just like 100% classic 80s cool. A character just kind of takes everything in stride. Even getting a sword jammed through him doesn't really register. Like, how can you not love that attitude? Not to mention all the environments had character and intrigue to them. Like, how did the sequel take all of this and just sandblast that intricate detail off? And so, Devil May Cry 1 piqued my interest, but it was the Tokyo Game Show trailer for the third game that I saw on GameTrailers.com, which would absolutely blow my mind and make me obsessed with the series. I remember watching this trailer just over and over. It definitely clocked more time into watching this trailer than most full-length movies. And it still slaps even to this day. And after seeing that, I just couldn't get enough info of Devil May Cry 3. I found myself carrying around my collection of Game Informer magazines that had previews of the game to read whenever I had a free moment. Like, my backpack was just half filled with school books, and the other half had about a half dozen magazines that I could just reread an article about Devil May Cry 3 for like the 50th time or whatever. And thankfully, my obsession was well rewarded when the game came out, because it was fantastic. It wasn't just Devil May Cry 1 plus more. It was phenomenal. And yeah, it was tough. The Western version of the game had its normal mode turned into the Japanese hard mode. That was fine by me. I beat the first level without having to knock things down to easy. And the first two levels were so unbelievably fun to play. I know I've replayed the pair so many times. I've probably spent more time just playing those two levels than the rest of the game or most games. Not to say the rest of the game is bad, far from it. It is super fun, and watching Dante has never been more enjoyable than here. The bosses have personality for him to play off of, and the game is just like awesomeness concentrated and distilled into like a pure crystal, and I am all here for it. Now, normally I'd rank the original game as more influential, but Devil May Cry 3 is just a special case for me. I don't think I've beaten the original Devil May Cry game since the third game came out. So it's been like over 20 years for me. Whereas Devil May Cry 3, I've completed this game several times. There was multiple times on the original PlayStation 2, and then also the special edition that came out for that console as well. And then the HD remasters on PlayStation 3, and then the HD remaster on PlayStation 4. It just wouldn't be fair to give this slot to Devil May Cry 1, considering how much I just love Devil May Cry 3. I see Devil May Cry 1 as like an old friend that I've drifted away from. Not because of anything bad necessarily, we just went on two different paths in life. Whereas Devil May Cry 3 was the one I've been friends with since the start, and we've never parted. It just means that much to me. I'd put a ring on this game if I could, but I don't think that's possible. And if it were, I don't think they'd accept the ring just because they're already married to Demon Slaying, which, fair enough.